e to the j theta is a complex number in a polar form and represented in a complex plane as a vector with magnitude of a and phase of theta. Theta represents the angle of the vector from the positive x-axis. If theta is variable, for instance, if theta is a function of time, then as time goes on, theta increases and the vector rotates in a complex plane. The speed of rotation is determined by the angle of frequency omega. As omega increases, the speed of rotation increases. Theta can also be a function of omega while the time is constant. At that case, the speed of rotation is determined by time. This is the continuous time complex exponential. Here we have the continuous time complex exponential as well as its front, top, and side views. The top view shows the real part of the complex exponential, while the side view is showing the imaginary part. The real part of the complex exponential is the cosine function from Euler's formula, while the imaginary part is sine. If the complex exponential is discrete, then it is defined only on a specific point of time. The time is discretized, and then instead of t, theta is a function of n, where n is integer. Discrete complex exponential function is defined only at n equals 1, n equals 2, n equals 3, and so on. If the angular frequency, for instance, is equal to pi over 3, then the first point is at pi over 3 times 1, at 60 degrees from the positive x-axis. The second point is at pi over 3 times 2, which is 120 degrees. The third point is at 180 degrees, the fourth at 240, and so on. Each point is a complex number, or a vector with the same magnitude rotated with different angle in a complex plane. Since n is integer, then the angles of the samples constructing the signals are integer multiple of each other, meaning if omega is pi over 3, then the first sample is located at angle of pi over 3, the second sample is at 2 pi over 3, the third is at 3 pi over 3, the fourth is at 4 pi over 3, and so on. This is a very interesting phenomena that doesn't happen in a continuous time. If omega is increased by 2 pi, all the samples get back to their original locations. Let's clarify this. Now omega is pi over 3. If we sweep omega so that it is increased by 2 pi, the first sample associated with n equals 1 should rotate 2 pi from its position, a one full cycle of rotation. At the same time, the second sample associated with n equals 2 should rotate an angle of 2 times 2 pi, or 2 cycles. The third sample will rotate 3 cycles, and so on. So all the samples will rotate n cycles based on their n to get back to their locations. Since each sample gets back to its original location, then we get the same signal back by adding 2 pi to the angular frequency. What does this mean? That means the discrete time complex exponential is limited by a frequency range of width 2 pi. Discrete time complex exponential only has fixed set of frequencies. If we have a discrete time complex exponential with frequency omega, if we increase omega by 2 pi, we get the same complex exponential since e to the 2 pi is 1. That doesn't happen in continuous time. In continuous time complex exponential, we can increase the frequency indefinitely and we still get different signals. Whereas in discrete time complex exponential, if we keep increasing the frequency, we repeat the same signal each 2 pi of omega. That's called frequency aliasing, a phenomenon related to discrete time signals. If we have a discrete time complex exponential with omega of 0.2 times 2 pi, then by adding 2 pi to omega, we get the same signal. So frequency of 0.2 times 2 pi is the same as 1.2 times 2 pi. It is also the same as 2.2 times 2 pi, and 3.2 times 2 pi, and so on. If you have a complex exponential sequence, if you compute the sequence at any of these frequencies, you will get the same sequence. There is no difference between all of these frequencies. They are the same even though they are different numbers. We call these signals aliases of one another. They have different frequencies, but they give the same sequence, and all of their frequencies are called aliases of one another. We can go to higher and higher frequencies, and these frequencies are aliased, or they are equivalent to lower frequencies. Everything is aliasing back to lower frequencies. Because of aliasing in discrete time signal, we define what's called the fundamental interval. The fundamental interval is from minus pi to pi of omega, and all of other frequencies outside the fundamental interval have their own aliases back to the fundamental interval. We can define the fundamental interval to be any 2 pi interval, but the most common is from minus pi to pi and from 0 to 2 pi. So you pick a fundamental interval, and any other frequency outside that interval is having a frequency alias in the fundamental interval. I prefer using minus pi to pi, since pi is the highest frequency you can use. Let's look at this example. If we have a frequency of 4 pi over 3, meaning the samples are spaced by 240 degrees from each other in a complex plane, from the aliasing property, it looks effectively the same as minus 2 pi over 3, meaning the samples are spaced by minus 120 degrees. So frequencies from pi to 2 pi can be mapped to frequencies from 0 to minus pi from aliasing. As you can see, all the frequencies are lying on a unit circle. This unit circle defines the fundamental interval, from 0 to pi and from 0 to minus pi. As we move along the circle, we start to repeat the same frequencies over and over again. There is no more frequencies than that. The continuous time complex exponential is always periodic no matter what the frequency. Discrete time complex exponential, on the other hand, is periodic if and only if the frequency is rational number times 2 pi, meaning if is a rational number, where rational number is integer divided by integer. And that perfectly makes sense. Rational numbers in the numerator guarantees that we have integer number of cycles, or rational numbers of 2 pi's, so that when divided by some integer, we distribute that number of cycles over that number of samples in the denominator. In other words, we complete the rotation of that number of cycles in the numerator by the number of samples in the denominator. So periodic discrete time complex exponential means there is number of samples repeat themselves over and over. The period is the number of samples that repeat. If the frequency is not rational, then the sequence is not periodic. If you look at the complex plane, you find out that the samples of periodic discrete time signals are equally spaced and aligned to each other, unlike in the non-periodic signals. Same thing applies to discrete time cosine and sine functions. They're just the real and imaginary parts of the complex exponential.